Hello and welcome to Future Perfect Tech Shorts. I'm Tony Velasquez. One of the tech world's major annual electronics exhibitions has just concluded in Berlin, Germany. IFA, or the Internationale Funkausstellung, was the stage for leading technology companies to introduce their latest consumer gadgets. The Manila Bulletin tech editor Art Samaniego recently returned from his coverage of IFA 2017, care of the Taiwanese electronics company Acer. Art, thanks for coming over to Future Perfect.
Thanks for having me again, Tony.
Welcome back from IFA. IFA this year, compared to the other IFA exhibitions you've attended, what was the main difference?
They say that this one is bigger compared last year. Mm.
Did they add anything different? So, every year we find the same augmented reality headsets, virtual reality headsets. What else did you see differently?
So this year it's more of the same. Mm. So the same laptops and desktops, okay. The same AR, MR, and VR headsets. Mm-hmm. Of course, there are phones, there are TVs. They added now the voice control powered apps devices.
So that's because of all the AI that's going into devices nowadays.
Yes.
You've got, of course, you've got Alexa.
Alexa, Cortana.
Cortana, Siri, of course, is still there.
And Samsung has Bixby.
And Bixby, yeah. Mm. Right. So because this was basically also a showcase for a lot of the tech companies to introduce new products, and Acer at the forefront before IFA began already had their own introduction to their own devices. What did they show?
So Acer showed their three new convertibles, laptops, mm-hmm. the Predator series, the Powbo.
Yeah.
So that's the for the pets.
Yeah.
Also, they showed the 360 cameras.
Okay.
So for the laptops, for the convertibles, Swift and Spin series of laptops.
So you've got, I think all of them are letter S.
Yes.
So you've got Spin, Swift and Switch.
Switch, yeah.
And the Switch. You know, I think one of the two-in-one devices primarily has a lot of high-end features. Tell us a little bit about
that. I think that's the black series, the 7, Swift 7 Black.
Okay.
Yeah. So this Swift 7 Black is using the next generation Intel processor. Intel said the power is 44%. This is 44% more powerful, mm-hmm. but without impact on the camera,
on the battery.
On the battery.
Yeah.
And this one is powered by NVIDIA.
So you've got an NVIDIA graphics processor already in it.
In a very
chassis. And next gen Intel Core processor.
Yes.
When we look at all of these slim laptops and two-in-one devices, it used to be that in previous years that they'd be using the Intel Core M for a mobile processor, which actually delivered only power like a netbook.
Yeah. So this time they have made these really slim devices very powerful using the next generation of processors.
Yeah.
So mas mabilis, mas matulin, mas manipis, and there's no impact on the battery.
And it handles graphics separately from the processor because it's got its own GPU.
Yes, and they say you can now use this for gaming.
Yeah,
but not really the hardcore gaming because they have the solution for that one, the Predator.
The Predator, gaming
series. So they also launched the Orion series of desktops. So these ones are powered by i9 processors.
Oh, bago na. i9
processors.
And this is just for the Orion?
For the Orion series.
Uh-huh.
And this
is
one,
the tower computer,
yeah. Very big computer. Mm. Now they put wheels in it so that you can move it anywhere you want to move it.
You can wheels
it. So very, very heavy, very powerful device.
Yeah. So a lot of these, I guess, new processors are coming out in these devices. Do you think there's a market for that in the Philippines?
For the Predator,
they
say that they have the market for that one.
Okay.
So
there's a big esports culture here in the Philippines.
Yes. Even the laptops, the Predator laptops in the Philippines, they were surprised that it's selling really good.
Despite the price. Philippines.
Despite the price, yeah, it's more than 100,000. But you can buy one, the lowest model now, for 99,000 pesos only.
Only. Only pay. Right? So in fact, aside from the, of course, the gaming hardware that Acer came out with, you've got all of these productivity devices from the Switch, the Spin, and the Switch, Spin, and Swift series. Are there still 2-in-1 devices in this lineup?
Well, the Switch,
yeah,
you can switch it from desktop, from laptop to tablet
mode.
Okay.
So basically, the same configuration.
The same configuration. Yeah. You can do it like the Switch before.
Right.
So now they only made it more powerful.
Okay. So more higher end processor,
specs,
I guess, with graphics involved.
Yes.
And there's another device. I think it was supposedly meant for your dog, which is the Powbo.
Yeah.
And now the Powbo is actually even enhanced.
So the Powbo now, there's a Powbo and there's a Wagtag.
Okay.
The Wagtag is a collar for your dog.
Okay.
So you just put it on your dog, and this device has, they say, it has an AI or artificial intelligence that would tell you of any impact that happens to your dog. For example, sinipa yung aso mo. You will be alerted through your mobile phone that something happened to your dog.
Okay.
Sudden fall or sudden impact, you will be messaged by
the collar. Okay.
So there's one funny thing about this Wagtag is that if there are lots of dogs and all of them are barking,
okay,
and once your dog barks, you will be informed that your dog bark.
Why? Why do you need to know?
So you need.
If you're very concerned
with your dog, what's happening to your dog?
Yeah.
So you would know. It's like a Fitbit for dogs. So you'd know everything that happens to your dog. So ito yung para sa mga panatikong nag-aalaga ng aso.
I just don't know why Acer the only company that has something like this.
No, Acer acquired Powbo.
Okay.
So it's a different company.
It used to be a separate company.
A separate company.
And now it's an Acer.
Yes, it's an Acer company.
So Powbo is meant as a tracking or a monitoring device.
The Wagtag.
For your dog. The Wagtag.
It's called the Wagtag. Powbo is a company, and they have another device wherein you can virtually play with your dog. So there are devices now. So if you want to caress your dog and you're in Japan, your dog's in the Philippines, the moment it goes to your feeding bowl, and you want to
stroke your pet,
you just use the app.
And how does the pet feel then?
Let's try it.
I don't want to try it. Well, you know, I don't have a dog, but do you have a dog?
Yes, I have a dog.
You have a dog, okay. So that's probably something that you can try out on your dog. It's the Wagtag is supposed to give you real-time feedback.
Yes.
On what's happening to your
pet. It's like Fitbit for dogs.
Can you use that for people?
Yeah. Yes, you can use that for people because it would give you signal also. But Acer has a solution for people.
Okay.
Yes. So it's called a GrandPad. So it's a
GrandPad.
GrandPad.
Okay.
So it's for a senior citizen.
Okay.
That would help them communicate with you or with other people.
But it's a GrandPad.
So it's a tablet.
Uh huh.
So if there are emergencies, buttons are big, and they can press.
So they have to use the touchscreen.
Yes.
Okay.
But very easy to use.
But I actually prefer the idea of the Wagtag because it's something that they can wear. They don't have to do anything, but the sensors themselves can actually give out warnings or maybe alerts. No?
Yes. So, but Acer has other solutions for that. Also, they have wearables that you can use.
Okay. Now, there's also something I think interesting that came out, and these are the 360 cameras that Acer also introduced. Is this the first time Acer is coming out with a 360 camera?
Yes. I think this is the first time that they introduced two 360 cameras.
Very late, no?
Yeah.
Yeah. But what's interesting about the new 360 cameras from Acer?
The Vision
360
is a dashboard.
Dashcam.
Dashcam. So you put it in your car and it would record and everything.
Okay. So hindi lang harap. Not
hindi lang harap,
front. Everything na.
360.
Okay.
And because of IOB.
IOB.
Internet of Being.
Mm.
They put in AI, artificial intelligence, again, in the,
pag inside this device. Pag sinipa naman yung kotse mo.
Yes, you will know.
Something happened to your car. And they'll alert you.
Huh? Yeah. You can also monitor what's happening around your car, even if you're away. So if you park your car and you have forgotten where you have parked your car, you just message the camera and the camera will turn on and show you what it's seeing. Where you park.
Oh, okay.
So hindi na delikado. For example, na you park in a dark place and you want to see
if there's somebody hanging around waiting for somebody to enter the car.
And because of IOB, you can send alarm.
Yeah.
So the car will alarm.
Ano to? Battery? Ano ba to? Because it's not connected to your engine when you're switched on.
Yeah, it's not connected to your engine. Okay. So it's a recharge. It has a rechargeable battery.
So